How many times while studying have you struggled figuring out what does your notes say?
Hi, what is up you guys? I know it's been a long since I actually shot a video. So yeah, today here I am with a new video. Okay, so for those who are new here, hi, I am Ankita. Currently, I am a final year chemistry student at University of Hyderabad, India. So today in this video, I'll be talking about how to take effective notes and how this has helped me in studying and memorizing things. Before jumping into the video, let me show you the desk setup that I have at home, the minimalistic desk setup that I currently made at home. Yeah, come on.
And yeah, this is my tiny study table where I usually work from, like from editing videos, writing blogs and getting my studies done. This is where I keep my laptop, and there's a small wall where I put my artworks. Like, these are some of the artworks that I drew, and I also try to put up like small positive affirmations in tiny post-it notes. Here I have like cute coffee mugs which I use as pen stands. In this I keep like the pens, pencils, rulers, all the stationery that I need for studying and making notes. In the other pen stand I keep all my art stuffs like Micron pens, brushes, color pens, drawing pencils, etc, etc, etc. And these are the colorful neon post-it notes. And yeah, coffee mug, and that's pretty much everything I need while studying. Now, first things first, the supplies. Currently, I'm using loose sheets, both ruled and white. And for further studying, I like to arrange them and store them in folders like this, which have hooks which can be opened. And yeah, all I need to do is to punch two holes and stack it in the file. Next up is pens. I use blue and black pens mostly. Blue for the main body and black for the headings. I usually prefer a black gel pen over a ball pen because I don't know, I feel like black ball pens aren't as flowy as the gel ones. Next up is the highlighters. I prefer using the fluorescent ones rather than the pastel ones because I think these fluorescent ones are more catchy. But yeah, it's just a personal preference. This just works best for me. Being a chemistry student, I need to deal with a lot of graphs and charts, and for those I like to use pencil and scale. Next up in the list is the color pens. So I got these cute sets of tiny color pens from a local store. This works best when I need to make some bullet points beside a note or mark something extra important. And yeah, I think that's pretty much everything I need for my note-taking process. Chalo, let's get started with the actual note-taking tips. So my note-taking process starts in the classroom when the professor is delivering the lecture. Sometimes the classes are boring, but yeah, most of the time I manage to scribble out some basic points and references and the topics covered in the class. After the lecture, I sit down with my scribbled notes and try to figure out what the contents have been taught in the class. I refer to the books and the materials which was mentioned in the class and do a bit more research on the topic from the other resources. I refer to YouTube videos also, and they can be a savior when you are stuck in some concepts. Usually my notes are the reflection of all these resources. As I mentioned earlier, I use loose sheets for note taking and stack it up in the folders. I find it beneficial because first, it keeps your notes well organized and sectioned. And secondly, if you want to add some extra write-up or an extra diagram or material for a particular topic, you can just add it without making your previous notes messy. I started by splitting the page into two or maybe three sections. In one of the sections, I would mention the reference materials that I'm using for that particular topic. Writing the name of the book with the page number makes it easier to go back to it when coming across any doubts. Then I would write the title or the heading of the topic in bold letters. My notes include quite a few equations and values that I need to remember, so I find it easier to highlight them using a fluorescent highlighter. Doing this becomes useful a night before examinations. And sometimes I even write all the equations on a single sheet so that I don't have to go through the entire notes while studying. As I mentioned earlier, I prefer using a ruler and a scale to make graphs and diagrams. It looks a bit tidy that way, isn't it? Instead of adding details of the graphs in another section, I just write it up on the graphs with a different color pen and sometimes even add sticky notes to add a few extra details. Making a flowchart also works best while memorizing the stuffs. I use both PDFs as well as the hard copy of the books depending on the availability, and if I'm reading a book, I would always keep a set of highlighters and sticky notes in my hand. I know a lot of people don't like to use highlighters on the books because they think it makes it look a bit untidy, but yeah, this works best for me.
So yeah, that's it for today's video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Thank you.